Hello everyone, and welcome back to today's analysis. Now for the 29th episode, I'm going to analyze none other than Rey Skywalker, one of the main protagonists of the Star Wars franchise. A simple orphan that starts her journey throughout the galactic front, only to confront the dark lineage that she came from, Rey can easily be viewed by everyone as a female version of Luke Skywalker. And maybe Daisy Ridley isn't as iconic as Mark Hamill, she definitely did a fantastic job in portraying the character. In this episode, I'm going to analyze all the information given about Rey throughout all the films of the sequel trilogy, to better understand Rey and her journey from an orphan in the desert to the legendary Jedi who saved the entire galaxy. Now, without further ado, let's begin. Rey was born on Jakku in 15 ABI to her parents, Dayton and Miramir. Growing up, her parents were scavengers and lived like nobodies in order to support their daughter. However, by 21 ABI, and she was 6 years old, her parents sold her to Unkarplat and left her on Jakku for good. They never came back after her. Nevertheless, Rey became a scavenger as well in order to support herself, and lived in waiting for many years on Jakku, hoping that one day her family will come back to take her back home. Meanwhile, by 29 ABI, a cold war started between the New Republic, the dominant democratic power in the galaxy, and the First Order, a new imperialist military junta that sought to restore the old empire. And throughout this cold war, an alliance known as the Resistance was created, as a military organization meant to protect the New Republic and protect the principles of democracy that were restored back into the galaxy after a generation of imperial rule. Eventually, by 34 ABI, and her entire life has changed forever. First, we come into contact with a droid of the Resistance, BB-8, that carried the map to Luke Skywalker, the lost Jedi Master, that could help to bring back the hope in the galaxy. The second of all was Finn, a former stormtrooper who defected from the First Order and joined the Resistance, as Rey eventually joined them in order to deliver BB-8 back to the base, but she wanted to return to Jakku, hoping that her family would come back after her, only to be later faced with the sad truth that her family will never come back, as well as the fact that she met Han Solo, a former veteran from the Galactic Civil War, as well as his best friend Chewbacca. And eventually the whole galaxy changed as the Hosnian Cataclysm, in which the First Order used their super weapon, the Starkiller Base, to destroy the New Republic by destroying their capital of Hosnian Prime, and a new galactic war has started between itself and the Resistance. Rey ultimately joined the Resistance and helped to fight against the First Order, over time which she made herself an enemy, Kylo Ren, the Master of the Knights of Ren, and the second in command of the First Order. Eventually, she was captured by Kylo because he hoped that she seen the map and knows where Luke Skywalker is, and she was taken to the Starkiller base to be interrogated, while at the same time they wanted to destroy the Resistance base to finally conquer the galaxy. Thankfully, that didn't came to be, but after the death of Han Solo, Rey eventually discovered Force sensitivity in her sighter, as given the fact that she was able to use the Force to take the Skywalker lightsaber and defeated Kylo Ren to a duel on Starkiller base, as he was destroyed by Poe Dameron and the Resistance forces. And with the map complete thanks to R2-D2, Rey was managed to travel to H2, where she found Luke Skywalker, the last Jedi Master in the galaxy, who wanted for him to join the Resistance to help them in the war against the First Order. Luke obviously refused from many points of view, but nevertheless, Luke managed to train Rey into the ways of the Jedi by giving her three lessons. And throughout her time on H2, the Resistance had its own problems against the First Order, as well as the fact that she learned the truth about Kylo Ren, the fact that he used to be Ben Solo, the son of Leia Organa and Han Solo, and the nephew and the padawan of Luke Skywalker, who ultimately turned to the dark side of the Force because of his own mistakes, and ultimately because of the manipulations by Snoke, the supreme leader of the First Order. Learning the truth, Rey decided to turn Ben Solo back to the light by herself, by letting herself be captured by the First Order and being brought to the face of the supreme leader Snoke. And while she was about to be executed by Kylo at Snoke's orders, he managed to use the Force to kill Snoke and usurp his position as the new supreme leader of the First Order. As Rey offered him a chance to redeem himself, he offered her a chance for her to join him, so they can both rule the galaxy together. Of course, Rey rejected the proposal and chose to leave and aid the Resistance on Crait. And at the time when the Resistance was nearly wiped out by the First Order, Luke Skywalker ultimately sacrificed himself to save them by projecting himself on Crait to distract the First Order and Kylo Ren, ultimately resulting in him dying on H2. But ultimately, he managed to pass the title of the Last Jedi to Rey. As following now Luke's demise, Rey has become the last Jedi in the galaxy, and has her duty to carry on the Jedi Order. But even without Luke, Rey managed to complete her Jedi training under Leia, Luke's twin sister. And now by 35 ABI, as the war one seems to come to an end, the entire galaxy heard a broadcast in the sinister voice of the late Emperor Palpatine, who ultimately revealed that he's still alive and plans for revenge. Throughout his journey, Rey managed to track down the steps taken by Luke into a previous journey to find Exegol, which Luke abandoned many years ago. Ultimately, Rey managed to find about Ochi of Bestoon, a Sith assassin. They may have a clue to find Exegol, but throughout this time, she not only did learn from Kylo Ren that what's happened to her parents, the fact that they gave her to Unkar Plat in order to protect her, and they were killed by Ochi in return, all at the orders of Palpatine. And finally, it's revealed here that Rey is the granddaughter of Emperor Palpatine, and ironically, despite being the last Jedi, she is the true heir to the Sith. As well as Kylo Ren give her more reasons to join the dark side, and ultimately to together to kill Sidious and take over the Sith Eternal and the Final Order in the process. They ultimately manage to refuse, and after a final confrontation with him on the ruins of the second Death Star, ultimately Ben Solo managed to redeem himself, thanks to the love from both Rey, his mother, and his father beyond the grave. While Rey tried to hide on Ashtu, just like Luke Skywalker did, in order to avoid confronting her evil grandfather, only for Luke to revisit her beyond the grave and teach her that blood is not everything. Some things are stronger than blood, and the fact that her heart is pure, unlike her grandfather's. But now before I go any further, we all should stop and ask ourselves, is Rey good? The reason why I'm asking this is simply because of the fact that she, upon realizing who Palpatine really is and what he did to her parents, she genuinely wanted to kill him, to the point that she even was willing to even go to the dark side of the Force to do this. And upon realizing the truth, ultimately she decided to take the way of the coward and hide herself on Ashtu like Luke Skywalker did. However, in reality, Rey is simply just afraid. Rey isn't a coward that takes the easiest way. Rey is not somebody evil that wants to murder someone. Rey didn't turn to the dark side of the Force after learning about this. Rey is genuinely a good person who tries to help her friends and family, and ultimately to confront her dark lineage. Thus, it couldn't be explained any further that Rey is genuinely a good person. And finally, after confronting her evil grandfather on Exegol, who revealed to her that he wanted for her to kill him so he can transfer his spirit into her and use her body as a vessel to rule over a new empire. Thankfully, that never came to be, but tragically, Sidious absorbs energy from both Rey and Ben Solo in order to rejuvenate his body. And upon doing so, he casts Ben into the pit as revenge for his first death at the hands of Anakin, only for him to try to kill the Resistance by himself once and for all. Rey managed to stand up to her evil grandfather and finally kill the Sith Lord once and for all, collapsing the Sith Eternal and the Final Order in the process, and preventing the return of the Sith. However, all of this came at the cost of her own life, which led to Ben Solo sacrificing himself to revive her and him dying in the process. But nevertheless, as following the Battle of Exegol, the war officially ended into a Resistance victory. The First Order collapsed throughout the entire galaxy, and finally the Resistance began to take paths to restore the New Republic. Nevertheless, Rey repudiated her Palpatine legacy and chose to take the name of Rey Skywalker in the honors of the family that she always wanted to have, finally leaving her grandfather's goals for power and conquest in complete vain. So in the end, who is Rey Skywalker? She is nothing more but a simple girl who wasn't got abandoned by her family. Girl that will go on in a journey to find herself across the galaxy. Person that will confront her dark origins and ultimately manage to save the galaxy. A person that could be seen as one of the best examples for a strong female character. Thank you all for tuning this new episode in today's analysis. I hope you all enjoyed. Please don't forget to give a like and subscribe, everyone. And may the Force be with you. I'm all the Jedi.